Comics may have had one thing right. Humans would eventually evolve, mutate into a superior species, one with magical and unexplainable powers. From X-ray vision to an infallible memory, here are 15 unusual people who have real superpowers.
Hey Mom, what day was Valentine's Day in 79?
It was a Wednesday.
Number 15. The Bee Woman. Superpowers can materialize in strange ways. It's essential to think of super as extraordinary. Doesn't matter what the trick entails, if it's extraordinary, it can probably be considered super. As part of an awareness drive ahead of World Honeybee Day celebrations, Jisha, a beekeeper all of her life, got her face covered in them. She wanted to prove the harmlessness of honeybees and their vital role in our society. Without a single sting, her entire face is covered with bees. I'm talking every orifice, aside from her nose, was covered with the squirming insects. I'm just glad they didn't start making honey in her eye sockets or ear canals. According to her, we consider honey as a vital preventive medicine, which can be consumed by all. If we consumed honey daily, our bones and teeth would be stronger. All should grow at least one honey farm in each house. The mother of two says her family's primary income is from honey and claims that having a single honeybee's yard at home can provide a profitable yield for your farm. Honey is that desired in modern times. With the decline of the honeybee, we've become disastrously close to losing it forever. When there are no more honeybees, there's no more honey. When asked why she decided to advocate, she said honeybees are essential for the environment. The extinction of bees will have a drastic adverse effect on nature. Well said. You want to know a little secret? If you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you'll have superpowers for the rest of your life. So what are you waiting for? Time to fly. Number 14. Harold McCluskey, the Atomic Man. In a classic comic form, Harold McCluskey was subject to a horrendous accident. He was showered with 500 times the lethal dosage of radiation and survived to tell the tale. To this day, he's known as the Atomic Man. In 1976, Harold R. McCluskey worked the graveyard shift at the Hanford Nuclear Reservation when a chemical explosion blasted him with a radioactive material and peppered him with hot shards of glass. He then, at the age of 64, survived what's been hailed as the largest human dose of radiation ever recorded. How he survived, even thrived, still baffles experts to this day. Even more astonishing was that he lived another 11 years. His death was attributed to unrelated issues to the accident. Not a single cell of cancer was ever discovered in his body. At the time, he was working as a senior chemical operator and was gathering americium, a plutonium byproduct and highly radioactive substance used in smoke detectors and modern explosives. For 2 months prior, the lab had been closed due to worker strikes, and McCluskey was left to manage the place nearly on his own. Mind you, the job is hazardous with a group of people, let alone by your lonesomeness. The results speak for themselves, though he was lucky enough to survive it. He had mentioned to his superiors that he was wary of resuming this kind of work alone, but his pleas went unanswered. Number 13. Phoenix Jones. Ben Folder's alter ego Phoenix Jones was the leader of Seattle's superhero movement, which basically called on Good Samaritans to take on the mask and cowl of vigilantism to clean the streets. Phoenix would often don a black and gold costume with a mask and fake six-pack abs equipped and insert himself into street violent incidents. One time he had been recording dousing a group of people with pepper spray to break up what he called a fight in the streets. Seattle police later said it wasn't a fight at all, and this is the issue with ordinary citizens taking the law into their own hands. Phoenix went into hiding after some backlash, only resurfacing recently after being associated with illegal drug deals. Two confidential witnesses told a police narcotics detective that Folder was a drug dealer, with one of them expressing disbelief that he hadn't been caught yet. Folder, now 31, and his 26-year-old girlfriend were arrested but were released from jail a few days later, pending further investigation by police. At the time of this writing, Folder, and thus Phoenix, have been taking to the streets in full force. Doing what exactly has yet to be proven. Number 12. Etibar Elchiev. When you find out you've a magnetic superpower, what do? For Etibar, the answer was to break a record by attaching as many spoons as possible without the need for adhesive. You heard that right. This man's body chemistry is so unique that it causes a magnetic reaction to certain metals. I know, right? The 41-year-old former kickboxing coach from Georgia held 53 spoons on both his back and chest, smashing his previous best of 50 and breaking the Guinness Book World Record as the legendary Magnetic Man. Becoming a world record holder was his dream. Now that he's in the books, he only plans to move forward, taking his stunts even further, testing his abilities until they break him or he breaks something. "I won't reveal all of my cards at once," he once said. "This power takes patience and practice to master." He claims he can stick the spoons to his body because he has a natural magnetic property. Still, experts have yet to study and conclude this evidence to be true. Either way, the trick has made its way into the pages of history. Not everyone, though, is convinced. Many claim that spoons would stick to his smooth, hairless body either way. We'll just have to wait and see if he keeps his promise or the spoons are the epitome. Number 11. Kobayashi. This competition eater isn't only dazzling the crowds at the shows, he's terrifying doctors too. Though they claim Kobayashi has a condition, they don't have a name for it. His stomach is exceptionally elastic. When doctors tested his theory by inserting a camera into his stomach and manually stretching it themselves, they found this incredible attribute to be true. In other words, Kobayashi has a superpower when it comes to eating a heck of a whole lot. That makes him the perfect candidate to put away some impressive numbers of food. He's likely the most accomplished competitive eater in the world. Known merely as Kobe to his friends, he often reaches out to his fans and answers the many questions he gets hit with. From diet to bowel movement, people are interested in the details. Unsurprisingly, most of the question sessions focused on his favorite foods to eat and how he goes about practicing for competitions. Number 10. Alan Robert, the French Spider-Man. Alan Robert has made it a career at being Spider-Man. Traveling around the globe, he climbed some of the tallest and most daunting construction ever built by man. From the tallest building in the world, the Burj Khalifa, to other towering buildings worldwide, he scales them with no safety harness or parachute. He's entirely barehanded. With nothing more than a sack for dry powder, Alan deserves the credit and titles that he gets. The 57-year-old daredevil records all of his free solo climbs over the world's greatest buildings, which often result in his arrest in the end. To say the least, this has done little to slow him down. Starting off with rock climbing, the sport focused his attention on urban buildings in the 1990s after mountains became too easy. To this date, he has scaled over 100 buildings. Each is as crazy and magnificent as the next. Standing at a mere 5 feet 4 inches and weighing only 114 pounds, his figure and hobby help paint the picture of this eccentric climber. He's a family man with a new son on the way and responsibility that's seen him reduce his climbing risk. But with an upcoming documentary called My Next Challenge and an unsatiated appetite to climb, his isolation may be short-lived. I expect to see him take to the skies in the next few years. Number 9. King Tooth. This person definitely defies all odds about the strength of one's teeth. A Malaysian, aptly nicknamed King Tooth, pulled a 7-coach train using a steel rope. On the end of the rope was a mouth guard that nuzzled neatly into his mouth, a feat that broke a new world record for heaviest weight pulled with teeth. Now, don't go out and attempt to pull your car with your teeth just willy-nilly. It takes time and practice to develop teeth strength like these guys. I mean, what's even more impressive in this footage is the bulging neck muscles popping from his neck. They're strained to their limit, and his face contorts in all sorts of expressions before moving the 297.1-ton train 9 feet, 2.2 inches in distance along the tracks. I don't know what type of toothpaste and mouthwash this guy uses, but I need to get my hands on some of that. For King Tooth, that wasn't enough. He partially attributes his strength to an Indian form of meditation, but hoped to pull the heavier train more than 13 feet 9.3 inches. With this in mind, he had begun training again to accomplish this goal. Number 8. Woman who feels no pain. While it's a matter of argument, blocking pain can be seen as a superpower or a curse. It's the body's way of letting us know, hey, something is not right here. While it would be undoubtedly helpful in some cases, in all cases would remove an aspect of humanity. Turns out there are real people that can feel no pain, though they have no control over it. Doctors have recently confirmed a new mutation in a woman who can barely feel pain or stress after a surgeon who was baffled by a recovery from an operation referred to her for genetic testing. You heard that right. She healed so fast and without any sense of pain that her PCP referred her to a study group. Joe Cameron, now 71, has a mutation gene that scientists believe plays a significant role in pain signaling and mood and memory management. The discovery has boosted hopes of new treatments for chronic pain and depression that plague many modern humans. She's experienced broken limbs, cuts and burns, childbirth, and numerous surgical operations with little to no need for pain relief. She even went into surgery without the need for numbing medication. She sometimes leans on the aga and knows about it, and not from the pain, but the smell. While mostly this has proved a good life, she sometimes finds herself leaning on something and doesn't realize it until she starts to smell her own flesh. Number 7. Stephen Wiltshire, the astonishing artist. There's no other description for Stephen Wiltshire than astonishing artist. With just a single flight over a city, he can replicate an entire cityscape from memory with remarkable detail. Take a look at his work for yourself. Today, he stands as one of Britain's best-known artists. His commissions have a year-long wait list, and videos of him sketching panoramic cityscapes in perfect scale go viral. Not to mention, they're mesmerizing to watch. Life wasn't always so easy for that young artist. When Stephen was in school, his teachers had no idea what to do with him. Diagnosed with autism at age 3, he didn't say his first word, paper, until age 5. Still, as a child, he exhibited the drawing skills of a prodigy, creating stunningly accurate images of wildfire and caricatures of his teachers. While he didn't pick up on his other lessons quite so easily, when it came to drawing, he had an understanding of the form like no other. As he aged, he began drawing the buildings around London with impressive detail. His older sister, a significant proponent in the art lifestyle, would take him to his home of a school friend who lived on the 14th floor of an apartment building so he could observe the expansive view of the city. He marveled at his mathematical precision, its layout, and landmarks. From that point on, she said, his passion became obsessive. Number 6. Eve Rossi, the Jetman. Eve has made his life's work to fly without the aircraft. He's made a significant leap forward with his Jetman invention. In a stunning new video, Jetwing pilot Eve Rossi has proved he doesn't need to drop out of a plane or a helicopter to fly. Now he can levitate off the ground using a new autonomous VTOL system that looks like the most relaxing way of flight ever invented. The footage looks so easygoing and relaxing as he cruises miles above the Earth. As you can see, he has complete freedom with his arms. He's using nothing but finger controls built into the gloves to navigate his altitude and direction. The Jetwing, developed with Swedish engineers, happily self-balances. Self-balancing is the key to making this a practical application going into the future. From there, he seems to have the ability to move around slowly in hover mode and land gently on his feet. I can't wait to see this technology advanced. We may be looking at the first iteration of personalized flight here, and there's a lot to be celebrated for that. Number 5. The woman who never forgets. She can't forget, even if she wanted to. Known to most people as the star of TV series like Taxi and Evening Shade, and the author of self-help books about health, diet, and lifestyle, Mary Lou Henner's first claim to fame puts her in a very elite minority. She's one of a handful of people confirmed to have highly superior autobiographical memory. Yeah, that's the technical term. It's defined as the unique ability to recall what happened on any day of one's life at any given moment. Ask her what she did at age 4 on July 2nd and she knows. Ask her what she had for breakfast on the day of her first birthday and she knows. She knows the month, day, and year of every event that's ever happened to her in her life, from major news events to personal incidents. If you tell her your birthday, she'll tell you the day of the week you were born on. About her extraordinary ability, she says, "It's just something I've been able to do my whole life. It's just there," says Henner. Who became aware of her ability at age 6? It's like the DVD menu or a hard drive. Everything is just there. I just gotta go access it. Number 4. Lightning Man. Being struck by lightning is one heck of a life event to claim. Surviving one is even rarer. Surviving 11 of them, now we're talking insane. A man who claims to have been struck by lightning 11 times insists he's telling the truth despite skepticism from experts and the Guinness World Records. Experts are saying it's not possible, and Guinness refuses to enter him without proof. Melvin Roberts, 62, from Seneca in South Carolina, claims to have been struck in the sunshine while driving a bulldozer and twice while mowing the lawn. Apparently, the land he lives on and works on is a hotbed for lightning storms, and Melvin has been getting struck since moving there. He says it feels like being cooked from the inside out. While there isn't any clear evidence of him ever being struck, there are multiple scars found all over his body that can be attributed to entry and exit burns from lightning. While we may never know if this man indeed survived such strikes, we know he survived something. You don't get scars like that from nothing, that's for sure. Number 3. Woman in the Lake. Before getting into this strange story, I have to disclose the fact that it's unverified. A 65-year-old woman from a village in India's West Bengal has allegedly spent every day for the past 2 decades submerged up to her neck in the waters of a nearby lake. She claims a disease to be at fault. Every morning, she gets up before sunrise and walks into a frigid nearby lake where she remains submerged up to her neck until the sun sets. The goal is to avoid direct contact with sunlight. She's been doing this religiously since 1998, and it's been shown to reduce whatever disease she ails from. When she started suffering from a mysterious condition that left her body inflamed and sore all day long, the only thing that seemed to relieve the woman's pain was water. As any of us would, she started spending her days in a lake close to the village. It's been her only sense of relief since the condition started. Dubbed the Indian Mermaid, she's been reported to only eat rice and some vegetables all day, as her condition and sedentary lifestyle have affected her appetite and body chemistry over the years. Her relatives usually take her meal to the lake, and she eats in the water to protect her skin from the sun. Experts are baffled at the condition. Number 2. Natasha Daminka. Over 100 years ago, German physicist Wilhelm Röntgen announced his discovery of an invisible form of radiation that could photograph bones and organs inside a living human body. Many scientists called the discovery of X-rays a hoax. Still, when the skeptics put Röntgen's claims to the test, they were convinced about one of the most significant discoveries in science and medicine. Now comes a teenage girl from Saransk, Russia, who claims to have X-ray-like vision, which lets her see inside human bodies. Like before, skeptics have risen to test that claim. So far, she's made diagnoses more accurate than those of doctors and with just a glance. How in the world is she doing this? If it is indeed a hoax, how is she accurately diagnosing them? Because, I mean, if she's telling the truth, she's got X-ray vision. Either way, she was able to pull off some remarkable stuff. Number 1. Monsieur Mongetout. Who said humans can't eat metal? This guy put that theory to test by eating an entire airplane, piece by piece, day by day. No joke, from the age of 9, doctors had said he was developing an unusual tolerance for his fondness of eating dangerous objects like glass and metal, which are generally indigestible. Doctors would often tell him, just because you can doesn't mean you shouldn't. It didn't deter him. According to legend, this first bout of unusual eating came about when a glass he was drinking from shattered. He began chewing the fragments of glass like a midday snack. Why this sort of thing was encouraged, nobody can really say. Experts determined his ability was unique in the world and called the condition pica. This, in essence, meant he had an unusual craving for non-nutritive items, an attribute found in other conditions and autoimmune diseases. No matter, he still seems engaged in the act and even went on to eat an entire airplane for a record. To be fair, not many people will be chasing after that one. As you can see, humans are developing some real-life superpowers that are baffling experts and citizens alike. Is this the future of humanity? Is the mutant concept from comic books an accurate evolution of humanity? Only time will tell. If you enjoyed the video, smash that like button, and don't forget to subscribe to get all our lit content delivered right to your inbox.